I want some jerk chicken, bro. I want some jerk. I know it's crazy. I'm reacting to a Coi Leray song, but everything happens once or at least twice in it. I don't really have like a lot of opinions about this song. It was recommended in the comments, so I'm here reacting to it. I haven't heard of it. I ain't even peeped it. I thought Shanisha was someone else. I ain't gonna lie. I thought it was like some random old person. It may be. I don't know. It'd be crazy if I gave like some real commentary about this part, but no, that's crazy. That's absurd. Immediately proven wrong. Great song. Immediately, don't even worry about the visuals. It's not about that at all. It's about the fact that they just absolutely flowed on this track. Like everything from the, you know. Over here got me flustered, bro. I don't know. I will say I don't know how to feel about this song yet. So I'm gonna let it play. But they play into that. They play into that role, which I ain't mad at. It's just it'd be crazy seeing it if that makes sense. They do look good though. You know what I mean? They both have cross tattoos and they do. Well, I don't know if that's necessarily a cross because that could be a sword. Because I'm like, but some people have imagery that's a sword and a cross. Where am I getting at with this? They're similar. What if Shanisha is the Coi Leray of Jamaica? Nah. Maybe she is. Maybe I'm not hip. Bro, you get me. I will always say though that Coi Leray do like remind me of like not of a kid, yeah, of a kid. So it's like it's more of Shanisha. That's a fine woman. That's a very nice looking woman. I'm not mad at the song though. It's cool. It's a good vibe. Definitely for today. It's sunny outside and everything, bro. Better yet, so many songs though. Like nowadays, not even nowadays. I was thinking about this yesterday. So many songs are about sex that is crazy. Cause you can find a sexual innuendo in like almost any song now. And it's almost impossible to find a song that doesn't. I'm not necessarily mad at it with this song, though, because, like, I guess it's kind of tasteful. I feel like, okay, tasteful may not be the right word. Tasteful, bro. I just got some hair in my mouth. Okay. Ah, man, it's hard to, like, give commentary when a fine woman is like, staring directly into the camera like that. But what I will say is it's a clean song. I do like the vibe of it, though. It's very, very, like, tropical. I don't feel like it's, like, more than other songs that are kind of like this, if that makes sense. Tropical songs that have, like, a pop American vibe kind of all give me this vibe. So it's, like, am I expecting a lot more? Yes and no. But I like it though. Making me bob my head. And I can see it being played at like pool parties and that. I can see it being played at more than pool parties. I can see it being played at like any just good vibe place. You know what I'm saying? Like I like this. Tyler gave us Joe Berg and Sheen. Give us Kingston. I'm tweaking. That's a location. I thought they were talking about the artist for a moment. Can't get it off repeat. This is a good song though. Like, I ain't even mad at it. This is definitely gonna like rock some speakers for sure this summer. I know some Jamaican guys gonna be whining to this one. Some Rodman in it. It's gonna be some mad youths just catching a whine for this one. Bare booty. Bare pom pom. Hey, real culture. Like, this is just a good song, though, like, vibes-wise, bro. This is definitely going on some playlists, man. Like, this make me want to be on an island sipping a pina colada. I don't even like pina coladas. That was just straight cap. Like, I just threw a drink out there. I ain't gonna lie. But this is cool. This makes me want to be out of my room. But, I mean, we're supposed to be getting this YouTube grind in. So, maybe later today, bro. I like the song, as you could tell, because I'm going back and listening, but like, it makes me want to, I like it. But that specific part, that's like what I keep kind of harping on about the whole, like, it sounds like a lot of Jamaican, not even Jamaican pop songs, but like Islander songs that like give the American pop like vibe. Because On It All Night, definitely one is like already been like a lyric that other singers have used like a solid amount, but also just like that specific part feels like it's taken from like 2012. I think 2012 to 2014 would be like a good estimate from like when songs like this were doing well. But like, it gives that vibe, which I ain't mad at though. I ain't gonna lie, because that was a good time, bro. That was a good time to be alive. I feel like I just got bit by a spider. This is just good vibes, bro. Like, I know, bro, like, just getting some, like, some women and, like, give them tequila in this song and, like, some Carnival, like, dresses, bro, and they would absolutely go crazy, bro. Like, they didn't have to do all this setup. They could have just given them that, and this song would have been insane. And some rum, bro. And I want some jerk chicken, bro. I why whole lot of wham, whole lot of wham. That's more than wham, bro. For a song, I have the rating that I'm gonna give it, honestly. But I'm curious as to where Coi Leray goes with this. Because I've heard Coi Leray absolutely butcher just absolute lobs of a song, bro. Like, no possible way to ruin a song. Coi Leray will just wreck it. But I've also heard Coi Leray have, like, good songs. So, it could be fire. It could be clean. It could be a real bop. But that's up to if Coi Leray does what Coi Leray needs to do. Because Shenseea has absolutely, you know, set this one up. Also, I'm probably mispronouncing this person's name. I genuinely don't mean to. It's probably Shenseea. It's probably Shenseea. I saw a tweet recently, bro, and it was like, if you take your man on a girl's trip, that pretty much they gonna do them. This seemed like this duo. They seem like the type of girls to do that, bro. Like, if it was a trio and, like, the last girl bought her man, bro, I know that, like, not leaving as a couple no more. What's play into that. Wallahi, fam. Low it, fam. Got me hot and sweaty in my room, innit? Why'd I bring a British accent? Bro, I'm cooked. I like it, though. It's cool. But I wasn't surprised. If she didn't go the sexual way, I don't know if it would have still hit. Because it's already kind of like a sexual song. I said sexual. Bro, I'm cooked. But no, it's a good song. I like it. I want to get more commentary, but I don't even know if I really can. Because she's flowing, though, I will say. Coil Leray's flowing. Show affection over the balcony. Bend me over like we stretching. And I ain't never tapping out like we wrestling. Throw it back on it. Got all these boys mad because I passed on it. I'm a fly bitch. Come on, baby, spin it back on it. Yeah, we so... Oh, what are they drinking? What that? And I ain't never tapping out like we wrestling. Throw it back on it. Captain Morgan spiced around. Good. You know what I'm saying? I support that movement. I don't know about Captain Morgan, though. But I say this like I'm like that. I'm not like that. Alright, bro. They're aware. They know. A Murakami tattoo would be hard. I know, completely different. But they are aware of the allure that they have. The appearance that they bring into the table, they look good. You know what I'm saying? So this is a perfect song for them to just like continue to look good. It's not a song that I'm gonna be like, bro, they're doing too much, yada yada. Like, bro, they're in bikinis and carnival dresses, bro, and having a good old time, bro. Like, who am I to hate, bro? Who am I to get on here and be like, bro, this is so bad? It's a very, I will say though, it's a commercial song, so. For me personally, I'm like, this is going to be good for like some days, but other days, I'm not bumping no commercial song like that. Because this sounds like it can be played in a Kohl's, not going to lie. Like, maybe not with all the lyrics, because the lyrics are kind of crazy, but the beat and the melody are giving very much like, for the common audience, for the commercial audience, which isn't bad. It's just... You know what I'm saying? I know for a fact it's going to be people watching this video for the wrong reasons, bro. Over here fiending, bro. And better yet, bro, let me get into my yap session. We need to get away from the commonality of sexual placement in media. I know it's been around for a while, so it's not even like a recent thing. And I don't think it ever will go away. Definitely not now. It's so accessible. And sex sells. Like, that is just the truth of it. Like, if you have a nice appearance and you know how to use it, bro, use it. You were born with it, of course. But I feel like this is about to turn a little wicked. And I kind of hope it doesn't, because I've been kind of enjoying the PG vibe with the, like, rated R lyrics. They're not even rated R, I'd say they're rated mature, but that don't mean it's bad for real. It's just, you know what I'm saying, it's one of those songs that, like, when you were a kid and you were singing and you were like, dang, I didn't realize I was talking about, you know what I'm saying, back shots and getting blown out over the balcony type joint, you know what I'm saying? But I mean, she did literally just say it, like, say stretch me out over the balcony. So, I mean, I can only do so much, yo. Start tweaking out. This is cool though. This is a cool vibe. Where Core go? Listen, she drowned. Core Leray so skinny, bro. A strong wave hit her, bro, and she's gonna be in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. I ain't gonna lie, bro. I will say, though, someone give me that look, bro. I'm folding, bro, in an instant. I'm joking. I'm not. Somebody who could give me that look and I'd fold in an instant. Ha ha. still a cool song. All right, since we've gotten to the end, I will say this made me want to be outside though, like for real, like genuinely, this song made me want to be outside, dog, and like just doing stuff. But okay, what do I give this song? It's getting an 8.2. It's genuinely getting an 8.2. It's a great song, good vibe. Don't got not a lot of complaints. It's really just that like one little bit, and I don't feel as though it has mad replay value. This song could wear it on my ears for like a lot, if that makes sense. As in, this song could wear on my ears because I'd hear this song for like maybe the fourth time in the day if I'm going like a long drive, and I'm like, nope, taking it out of the playlist. I know it's gonna like give that vibe because it's so pop, it's so commercialized. But it's a good song overall. I don't have no complaints. I'm just mad I'm not outside on the island eating jerk chicken and, you know what I'm saying, got a cup. But I mean, we got to make this money somehow, right? All right, I'll see y'all.